Hi, I'm Kevin Hogan, Director of Auction Services at Rock Island Auction Company. It's my great pleasure to introduce you to our final auction of 2013. Preview day is December 5th, and the premier auction will be December 6th, 7th, and 8th here at our state-of-the-art facility located in Rock Island, Illinois. 2013 has been a spectacular year for Rock Island Auction Company, and likewise for collectors everywhere. Before I get started, I would like to thank all past, present, and future consigners for your support. For our buyers, another special thanks is in order. You have made 2013 another record-breaking year for our firm and the number one firearms auction company in the world for a decade. A truly humbling feat. So on behalf of our entire RIA crew, thank you. It is no coincidence that our final auction of the year happens to be one of our finest offerings in recent memory. It contains some magnificent, historic, high condition, and probably most importantly, fresh items. The sale is diverse as it is spectacular, and these two tables are a perfect example of that. And keep in mind, this short video, I can only show you a small portion of the exciting items and opportunities we will be offering at our December sale. Two of the more marquee pieces in the sale, which also happen to be the most historic, come from two of the most revered presidents of the United States, number 35, John F. Kennedy, and number 40, Ronald Reagan. The first item is lot 1202. It is the immensely rare and iconic John F. Kennedy presidential rocking chair presented to longtime Kennedy family cook, Nellie McGrill. Known as a Carolina rocker, this chair remains an enduring image of the presidency and his personality. The chair is accompanied by a phenomenal family archive of documentation detailing the chair's presentation, which includes handwritten correspondence from Jacqueline Kennedy Onassis, current Secretary of State John Kerry, and Sergeant Shriver. Next is lot 1201. It is this stunning and equally significant, fully documented, cased, consecutively serialized pair of Colt single action army revolvers. These were presented to the then standing 40th U.S. President Ronald Reagan. Features an exquisite hand-tooled leather holster with important gold and silver presentation belt buckle. These revolvers were presented to President Reagan by famed quick draw artist and Hollywood firearms technical advisor Arvo Ohala. They come with a fantastic Arvo Ohala presentation holster rig. The backstrap is inscribed on both pistols, President Ronald Reagan presented by Arvo Ohala. The revolvers are documented by two official letters. The first letter is from Colt Vice President D.W. Davis to Arvo Ohala and is dated March 12, 1981. The letter is on Colt stationery and lists the revolvers by serial number as being presented to the president during his first term in office. Colt Vice President Davis states, "I was pleased to learn that you were able to meet with President Reagan and present him with two single action 45s, serial number 44102 and 44103, you ordered from us. It is an honor to Colt that President Reagan accepted these guns from you." The second letter is from President Reagan to Ohala and is dated August 31, 1981. The letter is on Reagan White House stationery. It confirms the Colt holster rig was presented to the president by Ohala and has the president's signature. President Reagan states, "There are no words to properly express my appreciation for the magnificent gift of the belt, holsters, and pistols so beautifully displayed in that case. I know you described what you were planning, but I had no idea it would be so spectacular and so handsome. I don't think you could really hope for a better letter from a standing president in reference to a pair of pistols. Just extremely cool. And when it comes to historical artifacts, documentation is everything. And both pieces have impeccable records." Now, from presidential presentations to some of my favorite, Smith & Wessons. This sale contains a selection of pieces from the award-winning collection of the late Dr. Don Anderson. Here are two of the finest and most intriguing examples of the Smith & Wesson 320 revolving rifle. As a firm, Smith & Wesson only manufactured 977 of these rifles, making them rare and valuable in and of themselves. The first is lot 99, a factory documented, spectacular, and extremely rare Gustav Jung factory engraved Smith & Wesson 320 revolving rifle with shoulder stock and case. One of only two factory engraved examples and the only one known to collectors today. Engraved by none other than Gustav Jung himself, this rifle was exhibited at the Melbourne International Exhibition of 1880. It will certainly be a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity for a collector to acquire the only known factory-engraved 320 revolving rifle. The second 320 of note, lot 98. Fantastic, nickel-plated Smith & Wesson 320. We'll call it a buntline special for what we'll talk about next, with shoulder stock, scope, and factory letter. Also one of the 977 produced by Smith & Wesson. Of great importance here is the extremely scarce nickel-plated finish, of which estimates suggest only 85 were produced. An additional intriguing feature is the period scope, which is of extremely fine quality. And being a Smith & Wesson collector myself, it's the only period scope 320 that I'm aware of that I've ever seen. I can't think of another one in books or have heard another one discussed within the collecting circles. So as far as I'm aware, it is the only one known. And now, speaking of buntline specials, look at this. Lot 1158. Once again, it is Rock Island Auction Company's exclusive pleasure to bring to market a documented one of only 30 manufactured Colt single-action buntline specials, the rarest of all single-action revolvers and certainly the most iconic. As you can see, the original 16-inch barrel was more than likely period cut down as they weren't heavily light. They were cumbersome, they had the long barrel, so a lot of the original ones were cut down, which is what we think happened here and was subsequently fitted with its current 16-inch rifled barrel. And while the barrel might not be original, the frame, cylinder, and grip most certainly are. Think about this. Rock Island Auction has been the only firm to bring to market original Colt buntlines, of which we have offered two, most recently in 2012 when we sold one for $546,250. This is a collector's dream. It is the holy grail of Colt collecting and at a fraction of the price. Other Colt firearms on the block at this auction? This is a beautiful and extremely rare Colt Model 1849 Wells Fargo model. As you will see, and as you probably know, it is the rarest variation of the 1849 pocket model, manufactured with a 3-inch barrel, no lever, and it's in pristine condition. 80% of the original case-hardened finish on the frame. It's toned mildly, but it's still present and visible. It's a 60% gun on the barrel. The cylinder seam is still sharp, still retains nearly all of its original silver plating on the grip strap. Just a phenomenal rarity in extremely fine condition, certainly a hole filler for somebody's collection. Moving on to lot 1077, here's a near mint 1851 Navy revolver. Unquestionably the finest we have ever offered. And as I'm sure you guys are well aware, and as you may have heard me say this before, in firearms collecting, it's condition, 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 and this gun screams condition. 98% of the original high polished blue, all of the cylinder seam, nearly all of the silver, all the varnish on the grip. It's a top 1% of all 1851 Navies. It's a candidate for, you know, guys who just buy condition guns. It's a perfect investment quality gun, and of course you Colt collectors out there, I'm sure, will be interested. And let's not forget, we have six variation of Colt's very first firearms endeavor, including lot 1072. This phenomenal and equally scarce pocket model baby Paterson. It's the first model of the Paterson, essentially the first Colt. Again, extremely high condition. You'll see 60% original finish on the frame, sharp cylinder seam, nearly all the varnish remain on the grip. This is a really tough one to acquire. And from the baby, we'll move on to the opposite. It's the biggest Paterson, and arguably the most sought after, the big number 5 Texas Paterson. These are the ones that, you know, most collectors are looking for, and we have one in the December sale. Lot 1304 is the very epitome of collectible or investment grade firearms. They represent the highest level of quality, craftsmanship, beauty, and historical significance. It is handmade by one of the premier French gun makers of the 19th century. A case set of elaborate silver-mounted, solid gold inlaid, World's Fair Exhibition F.E. Gehrink's Paris percussion pistols. They were featured at both the 1862 London Exhibition and the 1889 Exhibition Universelle in Paris, France. At both exhibitions, Gehrink's received a medal for good workmanship and beauty of ornamentation in guns and pistols. Another world-class piece I would like to feature is Lot 3377, an immensely historic, highly scarce, silver-bodied, gold and platinum accented Nazi Field Marshal's interim baton belonged to Werner von Blumberg, Hitler's first Field Marshal. Only issued to Field Marshals of Nazi Germany, these batons are scarce and unique in any condition. I'd also like to point out that these batons were issued in pairs. You had what they call a parade baton, highly decorated jeweled baton, and then the everyday use true Field Marshal's baton, which this is. And as far as I know, its counterpart is in the Smithsonian today. You know, one of the most prestigious institutions in the United States. So it is of museum quality, investment quality, certainly a highly desirable collectible piece. In regards to Nazi pistols, we are pleased to offer Lot 1343. Now this is an extremely rare prototype Walther KPK semi-automatic pistol. The KPKs were intended to provide hammerless style PPK type semi-automatic pistol for high ranking Nazi officials because they required an easily concealable, readily available small pocket handgun for self-protection. It is estimated only a handful exist in even the most advanced collections today. This is probably one of the rarest, if not rarest of all, World War II Nazi small caliber pistols. Last but certainly not least is Lot 3388, a highly ornate punch bowl presented to Luftwaffe Chief Hermann Göring by World War I comrade and July 20th plot survivor General Karl Bodenschatz on the occasion of Göring's wedding to Emma Sonnemann, First Lady of the Third Reich, with a presentation that reads, "With the best wishes for a newlywed couple and good luck in the future of the German Empire from your old comrade Bodenschatz, General of Flyers, 10 April, 1943. This video highlighted items only represents a fraction of the entire list of exciting auction items. I often tell people, working at Rock Island Auction is like working at a rotating museum, and we are honored to be the auction house marketing rare and historical pieces from our consigners through our facility and into prize collections all over the world. So let's take a moment and look at the December 6th, 7th, and 8th Premiere Firearms Auction by the numbers. Here we go. Over 650 Colts, including over 50 factory engraved examples, over 80 Smith & Wessons, over 100 Civil War firearms, 700 sporting arms, including 25 double rifles, over 450 Winchesters, including beautiful special order, standard and deluxe 1866s, 1873s, 1876s, 1886s, 92s, 94s, and 1895s. Over 75 Winchester Model 70s in rare calibers, configurations, super grades, and safari grades. 325 foreign military firearms, 250 U.S. military firearms. Come put your hands on some of these historical, rare, high-condition pieces at our preview December 5th, and come join us on the 6th, 7th, and 8th for this historic sale. We strongly encourage you to come and experience what makes Rock Island Auction unique and an industry leader, and what makes firearms collecting so much fun. For more information, visit our website, www.rockislandauction.com. For instant updates, like us on Facebook. Follow us on Twitter and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Hope to see you at the sale.